Holy shit, guys. This is a pretty big moment because this isn't just playing Black Flag. This is my first ever Assassin's Creed game that I'm playing, that is. Not the first one I've ever owned, but the first one I've ever actually sat down to play. And I decided that we were going to just jump right into a game. Took some suggestions, and Black Flag was the one that was chosen. Otherwise, originally, I was actually planning on doing the whole franchise from chronological release order on up to present day. But due to some time constraints nowadays, I'm not exactly sure if I'd be able to do that so well. So I'm going to just jump right in, see what kind of it's like, dip my toes into, you know, what this series might have to offer. And then we can go back in time later on. Big disclaimer. This isn't just my first time playing this game in particular. This is my first time playing an Assassin's Creed game altogether. So expect a lot of blindness here. I don't really know what to expect except for the fact that I've heard that this is apparently a great pirate simulator, which should be pretty epic. So let's go ahead and start a new game. No shit. Let's just do it. Start a new game. Yes. Sure. I don't know what's what here. I don't know if there's even female characters. Actually, you know what? I'll just go with the default. Hold on. Since I don't exactly know anything about this, I'm just going to stay. We're not going to edit anything. I don't know if there's like a difficulty slider. Ubisoft prevents? Yeah, Ubisoft prevents. So all I really know... Jesus Christ, that scared the shit out of me. Oh, this is fucking epic. Oh shit, they want me to do it. Okay.
Someone take the wheel.
Oh, this takes me back.
Take the bloody wheel. They've pounded us here, sir.
Firing cannons. To fire with your cannons, hold the right mouse and move the thingy. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. Shoot the hull for maximum damage.
Let's move. Fire! There
they go. This is gonna be fucking great.
Ready to fire, Captain. Fire!
I hope I'm shooting... Because that one didn't have a health bar above it.
We'll give a good broadside. Ready!
The big motherfucker is coming back.
Trouble coming in.
Looks
like a fregat.
Royal Navy, ready to box, sir.
Unload all the shot we have.
Oh, that is so satisfying. Fire. Oh, I've got swivels too, actually. But right now we want to sink.
The magazine!
Let's go now!
Douse the flames! Get in there!
Now, who is the... Yeah. I was gonna say. Well. That didn't exactly work out. I don't know what the fuck's going on, but that takes me back, guys.
Is it dangerous? Edward.
Huh? It's hella dangerous.
Privateering. Is it dangerous?
Wouldn't pay so nice if it weren't.
Why not sail with the King's Navy? Earn a proper wage. Sail under gentlemen.
Sod the Navy's gentlemen. For every shilling I'd earn, the captain would get 600. That's no way to earn a fortune.
We don't need a fortune.
It's not about need, Caroline. I want food that don't make me sick. I want walls that hold back the wind. I want a decent life.
How long would you be gone with these privateers?
A year, I reckon. Two at the most.
That's a lot of time to ask for, you know.
All right. No more than two. Promise me.
Okay, so... what a lucky motherfucker. Oh, this game's... I don't remember when this game came out. I keep wanting to say 2014, but that sounds like not long enough ago. I don't actually know when this game released. Because it looks pretty damn good. And I should have all the settings up. Should, in quotations, because I don't know for sure. Oh, actually, while I've got a moment here, let me just make... What the fuck am I looking at? Let me go into options. There's a couple things I need to do here. First, I need to edit my sound a little bit, so we'll just lower the effects volume down. I'll leave the volume of the voices up. Sea shanties. Uh-oh. That's gonna be pretty epic. After the most recent Windows update, my audio on the PC has been boosted by like 200%, so my ears kind of bleed whenever anything happens. In general, I mean. But I wanted to take a look at general. Okay, no. Oh, subtitles here, yeah. On. I always have subtitles on for people. Now, I don't know if, like, this game is open world. I don't know if it's, like, a linear storytelling game. I'm not really sure. The only real thing I know about Assassin's Creed is that it's about assassins, obviously, and that it has an interconnected universe that shares a universe with Far Cry, at least theory-wise. And I'm a huge Far Cry fan. So this is our main character, I suppose.
Was it good for you as well? Havana. I must get to Havana. Well, nope. I'll just build us another ship, will I?
Don't do it.
I can pay you. Isn't that the sound you pirates like best? 100 escudos.
Keep talking.
Will you or won't you?
You don't have that gold on you now, do you?
Of course he doesn't. Ooh!
Bloody fucking pirates!
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna work. I doubt flintlock pistols work when waterlogged.
I'm on to you, Snakesby!
That voice sounds awfully familiar. Well,
come
yeah.
Come on, mate. We're off to a bad start.
That's another thing I wanted to check, the sensitivity here. It's good to get these things out of the way as early as possible so that I can get right into it. Controls. Yeah, here we go. Oh, they've got a separate look sensitivity. Well, we'll raise it up 2 points and see how much of a difference that makes. That's a little better. So first things first is we're going to immediately look in the opposite direction of where we are supposed to be going, because I don't know how loot works. I suppose that there might not even be any loot, but... Oops. Okay, I can draw my weapons. Can I put them away? R doesn't do anything. Oh, it looks like I can't actually even just start swinging around to break stuff. Okay. Find the assassin. We've got a jump buton. Oh shoot, I don't know what that said. So I've noticed that the movement actually I don't know how well you can see that in the video, but I can definitely feel it. The movement is, like, sticky. Like, see, he's sticking to the tree. So it makes it very fluent. Like, that jump there just worked. Now, wait, hold on. I see a dead thing. Anything I can do with this? Like, no? He doesn't got any money or gold. Jeez, what a worthless skeleton. This place looks fucking great. Oh my god, man. The colors!
It's 100 leagues or more to Havana. Will you walk that distance?
Can I climb this? Oh, you can totally climb stuff. Holy fuck, look at that! That is totally epic. The way... Oh, man. I don't know exactly how dynamic that is. But the way that his arms just completely, like, followed the laws of everything there when climbing this was awesome. And of course, whoa, I almost jumped over that. Okay, the movement system is going to be a lot of fun, I think. Look, there's really anything that I can interact with. Am I supposed to be going down into a cave here or up? I'd like to assume up. They probably want me to try to learn how to climb. Yeah, there is an interior here, but it's got nothing in here. Except a dusty old campfire and some empty bottles, I would assume. Alright, don't mind if I do. Oh, that's epic. Okay, so I'm not actually doing anything there. That's the game doing it for me while I'm holding the shift key. So that's what I mean by it just being completely fluent. No extra input required. Yeah, this is what they want me to try here. Man. This is one skilled pirate if he's able to jump around like this. How about climbing this stuff? No, he doesn't want to climb up that. Nope. How about up these bars here? There we go. Shimmy around the corner. Oh, classic platforming here. You don't see this kind of thing very often anymore. Basically, every once in a while, you get an Uncharted game, and that's about it. See, I bet I could go up a little bit higher here. Wow. I mean, I know that it's all, you know, out of my reach, but they did a pretty good job. On that front. There's a symbol on the map that I was trying to see exactly what it is, but... I see dead people. There's an awful lot of dead people down there. Wait, where does this go? Nowhere. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Watch out now. I don't need to go throwing myself off. This doesn't need to be like Genshin. In the first couple episodes of that where I immediately threw myself off a cliff. Look. No pirate. No, just run-of-the-mill guy is gonna jump down from there and land on his tippy toes on top of the, you know, a stump of an old-ass tree.
Posh git. Where's he running to?
He is trying to get away.
Follow, and I'll kill you!
Well, you attempted to do that already, and guess what happened? Nothing. So I have my doubts, young man. I want to search around because I don't know if there's loot or anything. Oh my god. What did I say? It's literally called loot. Got 208 R in Silver Cross, which is plus 90 R. I guess that's going to be my credits. Or my I almost said ammunition. My currency. Okay, well, in that case, we are going to have a little look around because... So that was a chest, and it was sprinkling. That's totally the wrong word. I don't know why I said sprinkling. Just pretend I didn't say it. So if we can have a little peek around here... I'd like to play through this game, but... You know, don't expect it to be a really fast thing unless I find a lot of extra free time. I'll try to play this a little bit. Like, if I can play maybe an hour, at least an hour a day on work weeks in between all my other stuff, that's progress at least, right? That way I can finish it. I have no idea how big these games are, though, to be fair. But if the Far Cry franchise is anything to go by, you can be looking at a pretty healthy piece of material here in terms of size. Okay, this leads down to those dead people, and it looks like... How do I come down? E to hang. Okay, I see. If I'm not mistaken, I can tell that bar up there is made for a D-pad up in the top right. So chances are this is optimized for a controller, and I am using mouse and keyboard at the moment. It's working pretty well, though, on mouse and keyboard so far. Is there a safe way to get down? Ah, the ship. Let's use that. I see a chest over there. So far it's pretty open in where I can explore. In fact, I see another one over there. Can I swim? You bet I can. Better not be whales in this game. I better find out what that is. Tab, let's see. Edward. That is me. Never mind. Yeah, like, what are these? Viewpoint, not cinched. To reveal map. So that's what we pass. That's what that bird thing is. It's a viewpoint. I assumed it was something, but how to activate it, I don't know. There's a letter, a chest. Okay, so there are various different collectibles, as I would expect. Where am I going here? This way. Is that the chest that's over there, actually? Yeah, let me take a shortcut here. This one over here. Yeah, it is. Okay, so chests actually show up on the map. I'd assume they only show up, though, if you come into their vicinity. Since I don't see the whole map just completely scattered with that stuff. We found a jade statue. Oh, are there Asian ships in this? Oh my god, guys. Whatever. I love those ancient, like, Chinese warships. Though, if we're being completely honest, I just... you don't get this kind of thing very often these days. Not just games, but media in general, where you get to see the old sailing warships and stuff of the good old era. And when it's a letter in a bottle, because of course it is. This is even more Sly Cooper than I thought.
For several days, I'd stayed with my captor, Bellum.
What the hell? Okay.
I don't understand.
Anyways, as I was saying before, earlier when we were having that ship battle, if there's ship combat in the game that at least works somewhat similarly to what we just did, it's gonna be like a trip down memory lane, because when I was younger, because I absolutely love the Sly Cooper franchise. And I played the shit out of it. Now, as an adult, I come to learn that a lot of people actually have mixed feelings on Sly 3, Honor Among Thieves. But, I actually really love Sly 3. And the final chapter in that game is a pirate-themed chapter. And as a kid, I played the shit out of it. Because my favorite part of that was the fact that you got to command your own pirate ship. And you would go around and you could get into fights with other ships. You could blow off their sails, their masts, and you could board them and loot them, fight the captain. It was such a ton of fun. And you could go on these little treasure hunts and stuff. I've actually, to this day, never played a game that ever came anywhere near it like that. That style of gameplay. So that's why I was getting really giddy earlier when we were having that ship combat, because it was basically just like that. So there's a chest somewhere. I guess it's up there. There's a paw print here. What the fuck is that? Oh, it's skin. There's a dead animal here. Okay, I got bone and wild pig hide. There's fragments of something over here. Saw on the map before. Oh, I bet it's that glowing thing. Now, I'm no expert, but I don't remember these in the history books. Whoa! Oh, okay, I thought I just jumped myself off. I want to go that way. Nice. Oh, this is good. I like this movement system. It works. Okay,
yes.
We got a fragment. No idea what that is. It's a thing, I guess. Let me open this up, by the way, because... Oh, what the fuck am I looking at here? Oh my god, I don't understand what any of this UI is. It's a progress tracker and all that. Is it the database where I needed to go? Yeah, here. Because I saw that, like, there's people in here. This is Caroline Scott. She's born 1691. She's daughter of Emmett and Elizabeth Scott. She's born in Bristol, England. It's a prosperous family of merchant servants. Okay, so this was... This was the woman that we saw in that early cutscene, right? I'd assume. Just reading through her synopsis here to see if there's anything of importance to pick out. Yeah, first met Edward Kenway. Okay, so this is the same girl. This is basically my soon-to-be wife, I guess. Well, of course. Oh, they were already married. Caroline and Edward were married in 1712. Okay. Wait, when was she born? Oh, okay, 1691. Then we got Duncan Walpole. Died in 1715. First Prime Minister. Duncan was raised in relative comfort and ease until his 18th birthday, whereupon he joined the British Royal Navy as a midshipman with dreams of becoming a full officer. Yeah, the beginning of the game, by the way, had a pop-up saying that this is based on true events, with liberties taken, essentially. With his heart set on finding a post with the East India Company, he had a chance meeting with a fellow sailor whom he had come to respect and admire. And it was this sailor who introduced Walpole to the Assassin Order and all its teachings. Okay, I'll jot that down in my lore book in my brain. Secret Order. The assassins in England never heard from him again. Well, it says he died. He died. See? He died. False advertisement. Died. Okay, maybe this is like unofficial stuff, like where, you know, they went MIA. And so we just assume that they're dead type of deal, right? Because this is me, Edward Kenway. Born in Wales, 1693, rather, and died in England, supposedly, in 1735. Edward James Kenway was born on the 10th of March in Swansea, Wales. Oh, wait, okay, hold on. I'm getting like some crackling. I'm getting some crackling things about Assassin's Creed here. If I remember correctly, you're seeing events back in time, right? That's probably why it says these characters died, because we're reliving an experience that already happened, right? I don't know how it works or if that's even correct, but I think that's, if I remember correctly, I think that's kind of the whole deal with Assassin's Creed. So that's probably why it says these characters died, why I died in 1735 England, right? I don't know how it went down, but because this already happened and then the game is looking back on that type of a deal, right? Like, there's this Matrix bullshit, you know, or something like that. I remember that. Okay, oh my fucking lord, there's a lot on me. Note, not sure a Welsh leading man would be interesting. Can we do ADR to replace his voice? I know a great actor from London who'd be perfect, speaks in gravely RP accent. DM. What? What the fuck? Okay. Of course, within a year. Poor handsome Sharp gets the wealthier beautiful girl. This stuff just writes itself. Yeah, it do be like that sometimes. It do be like that. Is she a harpy? Does she nag him? Are we meant to hate her or what? Because I certainly don't want us to feel conflicted about Edward's choices. He's the hero. Let's avoid scenes of him drinking or gambling. This is why you should have played the game series from the first game on. To understand what the fuck is going on. Benjamin Hornigold. That's probably not how you pronounce it, but Hornigold is funny. In the Bahamas to reconsider their options. These were fanciful days for Edward. But as pirates know, with nary a whit of loyalty to kin and country, king and country. I'm assuming that's supposed to be king and country, but it very clearly says kin. Earning his fortune by the sword and pistol, and praying his end was never too near. Note, if we can remove some of the more unseemly bits of his personality, this is a great backstory. Edward's bound to be a hit. What the fuck? Is this a movie? Okay, and then we got pirates, buccaneers, and privateers. Often used interchangeably, there are a number of important distinctions to make between these infamous high sea swashbucklers. So you got pirates, who are criminals on the open sea who use... Oh, God. You know, I didn't even know that there was a specific definition between the different ones. I think it's important if I want to learn about this game's, not just this game, but this universe in general, that I'm probably going to want to read shit. Oh, we got ships too. HMS Intrigue, is that what that said? I didn't actually see or read it. I'm assuming that's the British ship that attacked us at the beginning of the game. And the Jacobite? What the fuck is going on with that thing? So that's the ship that we were manning. Oh, there's even a ship collection. This is going to be pretty fun. And of course, typically we got fauna. Wild pig. Okay. I just wanted to take a look at that. I know that kind of broke away, but... if I'm going to... play the game, I'm going to do my best in experiencing it fully and indulging in whatever type of little lore books that they give me to read, which is something that growing up I never used to do. But as I got older and, you know, could start reading, I started to actually use those things. I'm gonna look at what this thing is, see if I can figure out how to activate it. That way we don't leave it behind and have to come back later. Now it says viewpoint, so... oh, I see something up there. I guess I had to climb up higher. Oh, that scared the fuck out of me. It wasn't even that big of a fall, but... I wasn't watching at all.